In these examples, we're asked to find f plus g of x, f minus g of x, f times g of x, and f divided by g of x, given f of x and g of x. And we'll also give the domain in each case. Well, f plus g of x, looking at our definitions here, is equal to f of x plus g of x, where f of x is the quantity x squared minus 3x, and g of x is the quantity x plus 6. So to perform this addition, let's go ahead and clear the parentheses. If it's helpful, we can think of distributing a positive 1, which really isn't going to change anything. This would give us just x squared minus 3x plus x plus 6. I think it's helpful to always put parentheses around each function, even though with addition it's not needed and is needed for subtraction. So now we'll combine like terms. We would have x squared, and then negative 3x plus 1x is negative 2x, or minus 2x plus 6. So f plus g of x is equal to x squared minus 2x plus 6. The domain of the sum of these two functions is equal to the intersections of the domains of f of x and g of x. But since f of x is a quadratic function where the domain is all reals, and g of x is a linear function where the domain is all reals, the domain of the sum of the two functions is also all reals. So I can say all real numbers, or all reals, or using interval notation, we could say from negative infinity to positive infinity. Next we have f minus g of x, which is equal to f of x minus g of x. So it's just like this sum here, except we have a difference. So we have x squared minus 3x minus x plus 6. And again, we can think of clearing the parentheses, so we can distribute a 1 here, but because of the minus, we can think of distributing a negative 1. So this would give us x squared minus 3x, and then minus 1x, or minus x, and then minus 6. So combining like terms, we would have x squared, then minus 4x, minus 6. So f minus g of x is equal to x squared minus 4x, minus 6. The domain of the difference of two functions is also the intersection of the domains of f of x and g of x. So once again, the domain of our difference here is all reals, or all real numbers. Or if we want, using interval notation, the interval from negative infinity to positive infinity. Now let's take a look at the product and the quotient of f of x and g of x. F times g of x is equal to f of x times g of x. So in this case, we would have the quantity x squared minus 3x times the quantity x plus 6. So we'll have four products here, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So x squared times x is x to the third. X squared times 6, that's plus 6x squared. And then we have negative 3x times x, that's negative 3x squared, or minus 3x squared. And then finally we have negative 3x times positive 6, that's negative 18x, or minus 18x. Last step, we'll combine like terms. These two terms here are both x squared terms. So we have x cubed plus 3x squared minus 18x. So f times g of x is equal to x cubed plus 3x squared minus 18x. The domain of the product of f of x and g of x is the intersection of the domain of f of x and g of x once again. And because both domains are all reals, the domain of this product is also all reals. Or once again, using interval notation, we can say the interval from negative infinity to positive infinity. And finally, for f divided by g of x, this is equal to f of x divided by g of x. where f of x is x squared minus 3x, and g of x is x plus 6. Even though the numerator does factor with a common factor of x, nothing is going to simplify, and therefore we can go ahead and leave it in this form. F divided by g of x is equal to the quantity x squared minus 3x divided by x plus 6. Of course, if we wanted to, we could factor the numerator and write this as x times the quantity x minus 3 divided by the quantity x plus 6. Just be careful, we cannot simplify these x's here because we cannot simplify across this addition. We also cannot simplify the 3 and the 6, once again, because we cannot simplify across addition or subtraction. We do need to be careful about the domain of this quotient, though. The domain consists of the intersection of the domain of f of x and g of x, for which g of x, the denominator, does not equal 0. And since the domain of f of x and g of x is all real numbers, we only have to exclude the value of x where x plus 6 would be equal to 0, which would be negative 6. So we can say the domain would be all reals, or all real numbers, except x equals negative 6. We're using interval notation. To exclude negative 6, we'd have the interval from negative infinity to negative 6, open on 6, union, open on negative 6 to positive infinity. I hope you found this helpful.